Grayson, what do you think about Jake's proposal?
That was pretty awesome. I knew kind of before it was happening. I found out Friday night, and you know, for that to happen, and for it to just happen the way it did, and just, I mean, that was just phenomenal. And apparently he's famous on social media now. Everybody knows about it, so that's pretty cool.
You said you're in constant communication with Matt.
Mm-hmm.
Did he? He's had some pretty good games too,
yeah,
so far.
That Notre Dame game especially, that was crazy. I went back and watched that one. He did awesome.
What did he say about your game on Saturday?
He just said, congrats. I think this was my first 300-yard game in college, and he said, you finally got that 300-yard game you've been wanting. Yeah. So he just, we always are talking with each other, and he was happy for me, and I'm definitely always happy for him.
I know when it was going on, you see, like, Virginia, ACC, people say, well, you know, where was this last year? Would you kind of point out that, well, there were some games I was feeling it a little bit last year, and, you know?
Yeah, you know, every game is different. Every day is different when it comes to just life in general. So, I mean, it's not like these types of performances weren't in me last year. It's just, you know, a lot has to happen. Like Coach Rick's been saying, I mean, for the O-line to do their job the way they did it and kind of dominate the line of scrimmage, and for there not to be just a drop, you know, I mean, a lot of stuff has to happen. This isn't like I did something, you know, spectacular. I mean, the whole offense did something spectacular that game that, you know, just doesn't really always happen. And so it was a full offensive effort to get that stat.
Did you happen to hear from the two guys that had the record before you?
No, I haven't.
No, one of the Jets ones with coaching.
Yeah, I haven't heard anything.
You know, it didn't make a big deal in the game, but, you know, one pass that doesn't get mentioned, hadn't been mentioned by Coach Rick or you, has been Michael Chigbu's catch that kind of saved the streak for you there at the end. I mean, kind of what happened on that play? You seemed like you weren't very happy about what happened.
Yeah, I was upset just because I missed him, and I feel like if I hit him in stride, he wouldn't be able to run and get at least 4 more yards for the first down. And so I was definitely upset with myself over that one. But yeah, he had to make a sliding catch. I think we got 9 when we needed 13 or 14. And so that one was on me. That was definitely a minus on the throw for that one.
Grayson, I guess Auburn and South Carolina switched quarterbacks today, benched their starters and
really
put in new ones. Does it surprise you? Is that part of it? Do you ever?
It just happened to me. I've been through it, you know, and it's every day, you know, grind to hold that spot, and you're fighting for your job every day. No matter what kind of game you have, it all can change in a heartbeat. So, like I said, you just got to take every day one day at a time.
Is that in the back of your mind? I mean, you've got a game plan each week. You've got to carry out. You've got film study. Is that just something that stays in the way back that could happen?
I mean, I guess as a competitor, you're more thinking about, you know, beating yourself more than anybody else, because I feel like if I'm constantly beating myself and getting better each day and bettering the day that I had before that, that's really what I really need to focus on, not really like what everybody else is doing. But definitely, you know, as a competitor, you want to be the guy out there on the field. And so I wouldn't say it's in the back of my mind, because you're preparing for the other opponent or the opponent that you're about to face. But yeah, you always know that you're competing for a job.
How's your bank account starting to look after all these no sack games, and you get something else besides that?
I mean, I'm willing to fork out however much money at Ben and Jerry's that I have to for these no sack games.
They must love you over there. You're putting up for their school.
Yeah.
Please.
With as well as you played, to have your receivers and your targets not have any drops, yeah, how much easier did that make it for you?
I mean, it's everything for them to, you know, whenever I don't put the ball, you know, right where it's supposed to be, and for them to be able to catch it here, catch it down here, to know that you've got an area that you can throw the ball and they'll catch it 9 to 10 out of 10 times. I mean, that's huge. So they did a wonderful job.
Did that kind of keep you going if you had a bad throw, to see them do that, kind of bail you out and be like, hey, you know, I can keep it going?
Yeah, definitely.
Most of your teammates say you're pretty good at canceling out the noise around the team, and especially after Vanderbilt, it seems like everybody on social media was going nuts about it. How are you able to ignore all of that?
Well, one, before the season, I kind of, on my phone, deleted all the apps, the social media apps. reps. I did that last year at Virginia. It just kind of helps me not look at it, not focus on it, because it's really not important. What's important is in this building, and so that's kind of what I focus on. It's just, you know, what can we control as a team, and trying to be a good teammate and friend to my guys.